Hello, Andrew here from artisticbrit.com. I'm going to show you one thing which I think is pretty crucial. Earlier this week, I was in front of my computer with a client when all of a sudden we see the cursor on the screen move. And lo and behold, the next thing we see is a window close. We were hacked. Screenshots were taken. Credit card numbers were taken. And this had been a fear of mine for quite a while, knowing that our information was not as secure as it should be. So as a follow-up video, I thought what I would do is take you out in the car with me. I'm going to have two things, my iPad and my iPhone. And with the use of those two items, I'm going to show you how easy it is for someone to access your network if you are not protected. Now, I'm talking about an open wireless network where it's not password protected. If you've just bought a router from somewhere like Staples and you've plugged it in and you saw the network and you joined it, that was it, then more than likely you're on an open network and people can access your systems. So what I'm going to do is take you along with me for the ride, and I'm going to take you, like I said, with my iPad and my iPhone. So I'm currently in the car, and I got my iPad with me, and I've just gone into settings, and I've gone to network settings, and these are the networks I can see right now. Now, they'll come and go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drive around, going to park up and see what networks I can find. So I'm at the traffic lights right now, and there's a few unprotected Wi-Fi networks already. I'm parked up and I'm actually on the main road of Ringwood. So what I have is the networks that are available, and as I go down maybe a street, I see maybe, like, out of one street I might find one household that's unprotected, and that Netgear right there. So what I'm going to do is and they keep kind of randomly showing up, so what I'm going to do is just let me see. So I did. I was able to get onto the network of the Netgear. So I have another application on my phone. Go into Net Admin. It's scanning. If you see, it says there it's 192.168.1.0, and the router is 192.168.1.1. And it's showing me all of the other products that are on that network. So it's the Xerox, an Intel, my phone, a Dell, another Xerox. I mean, I can really pull up the network info on this. I was out earlier in my car. The last scene you saw was I was in my car. And as I was outside this shop on the main street, of the network that I had access to, as you saw, it wasn't protected. It did not have a padlock next to it. Someone was standing outside and they were kind of looking at me as I was pointing a camera at my crotch with the iPhone in my hand. They obviously couldn't see what was going on. And then a police car very kind of slowly came up behind, not too far away. So I decided to just get on my phone and make a phone call to Dee. And actually, she called me, so it was nice timing. So I got off and I decided I would show you the rest back at my office / studio. So if we start up a web browser, I'm just going to use Google Chrome. Here I have a brand new browser window. So what I'm going to do is show you what I could have done if I was still at that location. So obviously you're driving around, you find a location with an IP address that has no padlock next to it. It's probably going to be a Netgear, a D-Link, a Linksys, something along those lines. And you'll end up with, as in the previous shot, an IP address of a router. And it goes something like this. So 192.168.1.1. When you hit that in the address bar, hit return. Now, I do realize that by me showing you this, this is actually showing you how to do a very basic hack and access to someone else's network. That's not what I intend here. I'm not trying to show the thieves. So if you see this video, I implore you to get on your network, make sure it's protected. If it is protected, fantastic, you won't be affected. You still could be affected because I'm by no means a hacker. But if I was a true hacker, I would also be able to access a protected network. But the likelihood of someone rolling upside your house to access your network is less than zero, I think. So again, you've typed in the IP address because you've accessed their wireless network. You're now trying to gain access to their router. So most of the time, the username would be admin, or it might be left empty, and the password would also be left empty, or it would also be admin, or it might be 1234, or it might be password. There is a list of very basic, simple passwords that you can use to access a network without any protection. But the thing is, you don't need this. You don't need any of this if your intention is just to browse the internet or send an email by using someone else's network. This really is for someone that wants to cause mischief or create havoc. So you got your admin, you got your username, which I said usually is admin, and then your password, which in my instance, I've set to something different. Now I'm gonna log in. So now you are inside the browser software of their actual modem, actually technically speaking, of their router that's inside their home or business. You could go to logs. You can look and see what websites they visited. You can go to block sites. You can create some very serious trouble. And again, this isn't to say, look what you can do, here's how to do it. This is to say, this is what people can see you do. This is how they can track. Even in your own household, if you want to gain access to your own router, if you go to logs, you can see all the activity going on within that household or that business for the day. You can also schedule email of the logs to any email address, and no one will ever know. So this is stuff you don't want people to know. Here, attached devices. I used a piece of software in the previous clip, but this shows me my Mac Mini that I'm on presently, Dee's iMac, her brand new one, her old Mac Pro, my iPhone, this here, I'm not sure what this one is. I'm not sure. I'd have to have a look. That might be my iPad. And then this one here is the PlayStation. I know it's on. So yeah, there you go. So these are the, actually I think this is the I think this is still the router. Just another part of it. So that shows me everyone that's on the network. Well, I could ban someone from being on the network. I could stop everyone from being on the network just by messing around with settings. I could turn on remote management, which if I took it another step further, I could open up ports in here for the port forwarding. I could create by going to this dog next door is just howling and barking, driving me nuts. So the attached devices, I could see that there's 1, 2, 3 computers here. I could try one by one turning on port forwarding to each one of these IP addresses. And I could say turn on port 5900, which is the one that you really want to be careful of, one of the ones. So if in here port forwarding you see any services turned on, right now there's nothing registered below here. But if you do, then you really want to find out what these mean and why are they turned on. If you see a port 5900, in here this would be the name of, so I'll show you real quick. I'll add an IP address, I'll add this. Wow, this dog's unhappy next door. Then I can say edit service. This is the IP address of the computer I want to forward to. And I'm going to try 5900. Little code. Apply. Now, anyone that is trying to get into the IP address of this house could, by going through here, finding the IP address of this location, which is very, very simple, and then using software from anywhere in the world to access your personal computers. So I'm going to delete this because I don't want this switched on by any means. There's also other levels of protection. I've also turned this off on the individual computers of themselves. So that service is not switched on. That's for screen sharing. It's not switched on. And that's all someone needs to be able to access your screen, to be able to open files, take snapshots and of the image, of your credit card numbers, of passwords, of account info, whatever. Just they can dig and dig and dig until they find enough of the puzzle to create some real identity theft. So again, this has not been more to show you how to create trouble, but if you've watched this video, you know, drop me a line, ask questions below, I'll help you out as much as I can. But this is how you want to protect yourself, and this is how easy it is to access your network if you have not protected your wireless network. Okay, so this has been Andrew for artisticbrit.com, a site in progress. So please come back and subscribe, but please like the video. It really does help. Thanks again for watching.